I'm Dr. Ho, and I am one of the fertility specialists at Reproductive Partners in the Redondo Beach location. A lot of patients we see here do experience infertility. There are a few different reasons why a couple may be infertile. So we'll look at different reasons, including disorders of ovulation, issues with the fallopian tubes, sperm and male factor. Uterine factors could influence fertility. Age also can play a role in infertility. Usually we'll do full testing to see if there's one thing that's causing infertility or multiple factors. And we'll start with ovulation dysfunction. If all the testing comes back normal and someone has irregular cycles, we'll do further testing to see what the reason is for not having regular periods. So there are various causes that can cause irregular ovulation. This can include things like abnormal thyroid hormone production, high prolactin levels, polycystic ovarian syndrome. Sometimes extremes of body weight, either really low or very high body weight, can affect normal ovulation. And sometimes and rarely, early menopause or primary ovarian insufficiency can cause irregular ovulation. So we'll do testing to see if there are any of these issues that are affecting regular ovulation. And depending on the cause, we usually do have a treatment to help women ovulate regularly. Fallopian tubes are also important, and we do a test called a hysterosalpingogram to check to see if there are any blockages in the fallopian tubes. If the fallopian tubes are blocked, particularly if both fallopian tubes are blocked, then the main treatment for this is in vitro fertilization or IVF. If only one fallopian tube is blocked, but one is open, then a couple may opt to do something like intrauterine inseminations or IUI. In order to screen for male factor infertility, we perform a semen analysis, and we'll look at different parameters like what's the volume of semen, the concentration of sperm, the motility, which is the percentage of sperm moving in the sample, and the morphology, which is the percentage with a normal shape. Depending on each of these levels, there can be various treatments. So if the sperm numbers are very low, then the preferred treatment may be in vitro fertilization or IVF with ICSI, which is called intracytoplasmic sperm injection. And that's where you physically inject one sperm into each egg. If the numbers are just a little bit low, but still high enough, then we can opt for a treatment called intrauterine insemination or IUI. Sometimes there are uterine factors that can affect normal fertility. This can include things like scar tissue within the uterus, sometimes very large fibroids, or sometimes fibroids based on their specific location can affect fertility. Particularly if the fibroid is located in the inside of the uterine cavity, that can negatively affect outcomes in patients that are infertile. Things like polyps within the uterus can also potentially affect embryo implantation. Age also plays a major role in fertility. As a woman gets older, her quality of her eggs does decrease, and there is a higher risk of the egg having abnormal chromosomes, which we call aneuploidy. So as you get older, the chance of getting pregnant declines, and the risk of miscarriage and chromosomal abnormalities such as Down syndrome does increase. Again, I'm Dr. Ho. If you'd like to learn more about infertility and treatments, you can visit our website, visit our social media page, schedule a consultation in person.